The British public voted the Queen the most popular royal in the UK while praising her as a role model for the work she's done supremely well. But that's not the only reason she's so well liked. Every now and then you'll see a meme or hear a surprising story about the Queen of the United Kingdom and the Commonwealth realms, that'll go viral simply because it's completely relatable, and utterly unexpected from Her Majesty the Queen. The infamous pictures of her in sunnies and a dookie comes to mind, and we distinctly remember the time the internet blew up over her brooch that was apparently used to throw shade at the President of the United States. But more on that later as we go through 5 times Queen Elizabeth had us in stitches over her less than savory comments, cheeky remarks, and not so subtle shade. 1. The time the Queen's hat delivered a speech to Congress. In 1991, Queen Elizabeth made history by becoming the first British monarch to address a joint session of Congress. According to the Los Angeles Times, she was interrupted by applause several times and received 3 standing ovations as she delivered her speech. The day before, however, didn't run as smoothly. For one, the White House protocol officer didn't adjust the podium for the Queen, who's just 1.63 meters tall. As such, it appeared Her Majesty the Queen's hat delivered the speech for all to see. When she gave her speech to Congress the next day, she began with reference to her then famous purple and white striped hat, saying, "I do hope you can see me today." 2. The time George Bush added 200 years to the Queen's life. Back in 2007, when George Bush was still in office, the Queen took a not-so-subtle jab at the then-President of the United States. Welcoming the Queen to the States, the former President accidentally added 200 years to the Queen's age, reports The Guardian. He said, before she delivered her speech on the White House lawn, she helped celebrate the UD bicentennial in 1776 instead of 1976. George described the Queen's reaction after his blunder. "She gave me a look that only a mother could give a child." At a dinner at the British ambassador residence the following day, the Queen began her speech, "I wondered whether I should start this toast by saying, when I was here in 1776. In his speech that followed, George responded, "Your Majesty, I can't top that one." 3. The time the Queen denied a man who desperately needed her to give him a title. Queen Elizabeth has the power of honoring people by giving them a title. Sir Elton John and Dame Judi Dench come to mind. Of course, you'd have to have contributed to society on that level to be knighted. So in her book The Wicked Wit of Queen Elizabeth II, Karen Dolby revealed when Princess Margaret was talking to her cousin's husband, who was a thriller writer, one day the Queen responded in the most hilarious way to a conversation she overheard between the two. "I desperately need a title," he said, referring to his latest book. The Queen quickly responded, "I cannot think of a reason for giving you one." 4. The time the Queen threw shade at everyone who dared to wear beige. You would have seen Queen Elizabeth in sky blue, soft pink skirt and even bright lime green, but one color the Queen would never ever wear is beige. It may not form part of Kate and Meghan's royal dress protocol, but the Queen refuses to dress in neutral colors, even though other members of the royal family do. But she's got a pretty good reason for it. Royal biographer Robert Hardman recalled the Queen's word. She put it simply, "I can never wear beige. Nobody will know who I am." Karen Dolby also revealed a similarly hilarious quote from the Queen every time she's prodded to up her security detail. "I have to be seen to be believed," she'd say. 5. The time the Queen's brooch shaded Donald Trump. When the Queen met Donald Trump back in June, it wasn't so much what she said, but more what she did. Of course, it's all speculation, but one publication pointed out the Queen gave the President of the United States, the leader who said he'd preferring watching television to reading, a book as a gift. The book was The Second World War by Winston Churchill, a noted anti-fascist. Other publications pointed out the Queen's choice of clothing and accessories, referring particularly to a Burmese ruby tiara she wore as well as a brooch. Burmese people believe the stones possess properties that protect the wearer against illness as well as evil, Vogue reports. Not much is known about the powers of the brooch she wore on another occasion with Donald Trump, but many pointed out the simple fact that it was given to her by former President Barack Obama. Seth Meyers commented, "Usually, it's only her hats that throw that much shade."